much, Dave, and thanks to everyone for being here, spending the time with us for this special drive session we have for the product. We are very excited to be able to have the opportunity to speak to you this morning and then drive again for the remainder of the day about Buick's new entry and what we're considering the most premium and elegant in the Buick lineup. The Lucerne is something that, as we developed the product, we focused in on the factors that makes this vehicle a fresh approach to the entry luxury segment. We didn't want to just look at it as an entry luxury entry, but wanted to make certain that we looked at it from a slightly different approach. And you've seen and heard a little bit already about style, luxury, and technology, and how those factors are really key to what we've done in the design and development of the vehicle. In the aspects of luxury, we've really focused in on spaciousness, comfort, and the overall quietness of the vehicle. You'll hear a lot more about that a little bit later. When we talk about Buick's quality reputation, you hear a lot about it, and you always hear most of the time about the numbers, J.D. Power, always hard statistical information that you get back. But that has been obviously of equal importance to us, but we've also focused on the perceptual side of the quality equation and how that impacts our decisions on craftsmanship and the softer side of quality. We'll talk a little bit more about that this morning, but as you go through the day, focus in and concentrate on some of the softer pieces of how a customer has their first impression about the vehicle from a perceptual standpoint, because it really truly is an important factor in the buying decision. So overall, with the factors that you'll hear about today, we really think you'll walk away feeling that the vehicle takes you to what you find in a higher luxury product than what you would have expected. Next month, the Lucerne will start to arrive at Buick showrooms, and it'll be the first time in over a decade that we'll have the opportunity to bring a V8 engine to the customer. It's a real exciting opportunity for Buick, and especially with the Northstar V8, you'll hear a lot more about, and obviously we'll have a chance to drive. The Lucerne comes in three different trim levels, the CX, the CXL, and the CXS. We start off with the CX with 16-inch wheels and tires, a very premium ride, and as you move up to the CXL, we move up to the 17-inch wheels and tires, a more crisp, controlled ride, and the other marked difference is the leather interior. When we move up to the CXS, of which this is an example, we really have a surprising level of refinement and in the suspension, as well as the overall vehicle, and that is characterized with the magnetic ride control suspension, 18-inch wheels and tires, and a whole host of other things you'll hear more about and have a chance to experience. I'd like to start off speaking about the exterior and what our fundamental premise was in the design of the exterior was to have an athletic, bold presence and an elegant, premium vehicle. And the way that really starts in our mind is to have an athletic stance from beltline down. And where we've really concentrated to give the foundation for this is the wheel-to-body relationship. And especially with the 18-inch wheels and tires, it's really a tight relationship that gives the vehicle an outstanding stance. So with that wrapped around a really taut, overall a lower structure, a more formal upper structure, really gives the vehicle an elegant view and certainly marks the new direction for Buick as well. If you start off in the front of the vehicle, the Delete concept car really did provide a number of special cues that we'll be taking forward with Buick in the future. And one of those most important ones is the waterfall grill. The waterfall grill is really gives the front end a new presence, surrounded by a chrome accenting and really highlighting the tri-shield. As you move over to the polycarbonate and chrome headlamps, jewel touches throughout, and rounding out the front end, in particular with the CXS, in this particular version, we do have standard fog lamps and a bold fascia design with chrome accenting. You'll notice the difference between the fascias on the CXS and on the CXL and CX a little bit later on. So we start off really with bringing forward some of these special cues on the CXS that we just spoke of here. As you move on to the side of the vehicle, some of the things that we really focused in on was how do we make a premium looking vehicle without having to be ostentatious. It was very important to us to have tasteful accenting. And what we've done is we finished the theme, continued the theme of the chrome accenting with that around the windows, door handles, the moldings along the sides of the doors, and a reminiscent cue from the past, portholes. And what we have is this integrated, interconnected series of portholes, either three per side when we have a V6 engine, or four per side in a V8. In the case of the V8, again, the V8 being standard equipment on the CXS, and with the four porthole design cue. So it really gives everyone the reminiscence of the Buicks of the past. From a roofline standpoint, we have a 60-degree rakish windshield moving up to an elegant roofline and down to a faster backlight of about 70 degrees. Really rounds out the overall styling and elegance of the exterior of the vehicle. As we move along to the rear of the vehicle, what we've done is made the effort to really look at how do we make a clean, crisp look. And in doing so, one of the primary factors was to move the license plate from the deck lid into the rear fascia, providing a prominent place for the tri-shield and really cleaning up the entire look of the rear end with the floating lens tail lamps, we're taking a very prominent position. We have, in the case of the CXS, again, chrome accent along the base of the deck lid and chrome exhaust tip. So it really rounds out the overall premium quality of the vehicle. Throughout the car, obviously, you'll see the opportunity, numerous opportunities to look at vehicles where we've really focused in on gaps and flushness and the overall craftsmanship from an exterior standpoint. So at this point, I'd like to move on to the interior and start off by saying that really what we have focused in on is luxury, comfort, spaciousness, and quietness. Those are really the foundations. And we really did this in two different ways. You always have to take the larger, broader approach and look at the vehicle from a harmony standpoint, from an elegance standpoint, and we have all the theme really reflected in the overall interior. But there's the other aspect that has to be balanced, and that's the attention to detail. And you'll see as you spend some time in the vehicles that that is really a critical aspect in pulling this together. You can't just look at it from an overarching stylistic exercise, but also from the attention to detail and choices that we make in materials, et cetera. So if you start off with, from a refinement, as an example, when you look at what's important to a customer, when you look from a luxury perspective, what's refined about it? So you'll see French stitching in the seats, in the door pads, hand cut and sewn armrests are just a couple of examples. From a choice of materials, again, the material selection really does play an important part for the customer when they see, well, how was this car crafted for me? What's special about it? We have, for the seating system, and the leather seats, they're combined with a material called protein vinyl, which is a silk-infused material that makes the vinyl feel much more like leather, and also from a matching grain perspective between the leather and the vinyl, it also has a better interconnecting feel. So that's just a simple thing like that you'd say, well, we went the extra distance to pick something that really complemented the overall design. Other aspects would be the fact that we've got fabric-wrapped pillars, and that's a cue that you don't find really until you get up to that next level in the luxury vehicle selection. In addition, as I mentioned, on the exterior, the gaps and flushness in the interior parts were really another example of that attention to detail, and you'll have the opportunity to spend some time in the vehicles and see that firsthand. The other factor, obviously, in the design of the Lucerne was the choice of features. And you can look at just a list of features and say that that's important, but how you integrate them is the other half of it. But the list of features, I know Steve spoke about some of them yesterday evening. We have heated and cooled front seats, not just ventilated. A lot of products choose to just have a ventilated seat. Well, the cooled seat does make a difference, and I don't know if we'll have a warm enough day here for you to experience them, but that's one factor. We also have the heated windshield washer fluid, and again, something that is that extra special touch that makes the vehicle unique, and that whether it's the ice from the middle of a Michigan winter or the grime from the road surfaces and the after a long drive, it really makes a difference to clean the windshield off more easily. With our radio system, we have a Harman Kardon 9-speaker, 280-watt audio system, XM radio, and MP3 capability. And just a couple things as you drive through the day, two items that are always things that I think are important to have a look at. We have a favorites page, something that seems very simple. Every other car has one, but in the case of the favorites pages here, we have six pages to choose from. You can mix XM, FM, and AM radio stations on the same page. You can have one page, or you can have six pages. All these items that just make it more personalized, that you as a customer can select the choices yourself. And the other neat thing about the audio system is that it really is simple to use. As a normal knob to turn it on, to turn it off, to change the volume, to change the station. So even though it has a lot of technology, it's not presented to the customer in a complex way. It really is very user-friendly. So just a couple of examples of the radio system. We have factory-installed remote start, rear park assist, which appears denoted by the small round buttons at the back of the fascia, and a product, of course, OnStar, which is standard on all Buick vehicles. And as I mentioned before, I think as you spend the day with the vehicles, you'll get a sense that we have looked at style, we have looked at luxury in our choice of materials, we have looked at the features and the technologies, but not just as a list of items, but as a fully integrated system and a fully integrated approach to the design of the vehicle and the execution, and that attention to detail throughout. So you'll hear more about that from Ed Zellner, our chief engineer, momentarily. But I'd like to leave you with that, and certainly would like to spend the time talking with you later in the day and answering further questions you might have.
Ed, you're up.
All right. Thanks, Arianna. I have talked about attention to detail, and I know sometimes the engineering stuff can get into a lot of detail. But I wanted to make sure we pointed out some of the critical things. So I'm going to talk about the surprising performance and control that we have designed into the new Lucerne. I'm also going to talk about new and leading safety features that we've incorporated, and then also the pin drop quiet interior that we've engineered into this vehicle and how we did that, because these are some of the things that are beneath the surface that the customer will never see, but they are the things that make the difference. And the key to all this, the whole engineering team was very, very focused on attention to detail. Every part, every interface, every interaction was thought about, worked through, and optimized to provide the right kind of balance for this new vehicle. For the first time in 10 years, Buick will have a V8 in a passenger car. We've incorporated the Northstar 275 horsepower engine into the new Lucerne, which really provides a tremendous package, which you'll have an opportunity to experience. In the CX model, we have the 300 Series 3 V6, which is also a very good package, especially from a fuel economy standpoint. It's 1928 is the fuel economy rating on that. Also on the V8, it's 1725. So when you think about fuel economy, especially in today's day and age, those are very good numbers for a car of this size and weight. So I think the customers will also be delighted with that kind of performance. The other packages we have associated with this are we have really four different kinds of suspension configurations. On the CX model, we have 16-inch wheels and tires. On the CXL, we move up to a 17-inch wheel and tire configuration, and then that comes either in the V6 configuration or the optional V8. And then when you get up to the CXS model, you've got 18-inch wheels and tires. You've got magnetic ride control suspension system. You've got MagnaSteer that also comes along with the V8 to provide that extra level of control. And Brake Assist also comes along with some of those technologies. All the cars share common technologies like ABS and traction control. And then later, stability control is added along with MagnaRide and the MagnaSteer. So it's really a super, super capable package that delivers great performance. Again, you'll experience that. One of the things I wanted to comment on the roads that you're going to be driving today, in some rides you go on, I'm sure you've experienced this, the cars are put on roads that make sure that the car never looks bad, okay? We have purposely gone out and found some really crummy roads, okay? They're not all crummy, but they really put a lot of harshness into the vehicle so you can see what we've done to absorb those. We don't want to hide anything from you. We want you to be able to do a very good comparison of what we've done in this vehicle in normal driving, not just a very specially tailored kind of a drive with the new cars. I want to move over now to some of the things we've done in terms of structure. This model kind of covers two points. One is the safety aspect and one is the structure part of it, as well as the noise part of it. From a structural part of it, I wanted to emphasize up front here that some of the things that we did to improve the structure, we changed the engine cradle to make sure that the engines were mounted fully to the engine cradle and not a combination of body and cradle, which they were previously. It gave us a little bit more separation. It pushes the engine out farther in front of you, which also helps from a noise standpoint. If you walk around, you'll see some things that in the front of the engine cradle here, you'll see it's got some foam filled in the front there. And you also see some foam in the rockers here. And I'm going to pass around some of these so that you can see what kind of foam I'm talking about. This is not your normal styrofoam kind of stuff. This is pretty much sets up like concrete. Once it's injected, it takes less than a minute to get to that state so it can be processed in the assembly plant. And the purpose of that is to make sure that, in this case here, if you have a side impact, recognize that if you don't have that foam there, it's basically like an empty soda can or pop can, where it crushes relatively easily. When you fill it with foam, it's basically like a full pop or soda can, and it doesn't crush very easily. The key to side intrusion performance is making sure that the B-pillar stays pretty much intact as long as you possibly can. And normally, in a lot of cars, when they're smaller, you can actually, if you get hit broadside, you're going to pick up this pillar here and this one, or you're going to pick up this one and this one. This car is long enough that a car or truck hitting you may only hit the B pillar. So you got to make sure you got enough structure in here to absorb that. So it's very important that all these elements play together to provide that additional structure. When you look around other areas, you'll see other nylon kinds of inserts that we've added to do the same kind of thing to keep the structure intact and the various impacts. Overall, it also provides a very pleasing package from a ride and handling standpoint because you've got the structure to absorb all the energy and the loads. Other things from a safety standpoint, we have standard 6 airbags in this vehicle. And we also have the industry first dual depth airbag. The way that works is there, you can see in the sections that are here that there's one airbag that's larger than the other, and that's determined by the seat position, whether or not the occupant is belted or not, and then also the severity of the impact. So if you imagine an occupant sitting in the seat unbelted with the seat way back, ideally what you want to do is make sure the occupant rides down with the vehicle. As soon as the occupant's moving at a different speed than the vehicle, you've got a problem. So the sooner you can pick up the occupant, especially when they're unbelted, the better off you are. And that's what the dual depth bag helps us do, is pick up the occupants at the right point. Moving on to some of the quiet tune discussion. We've got a whole lot of various approaches to the way we reduce the sound and the noise in the passenger compartment. First thing we did was make sure that all the components were set up so that they are the quietest we can make them. Of course, not everything is absolutely silent, so then you need to make sure that you block the sound from getting into the passenger compartment. And then finally, you need to get it so that any sound that remains is absorbed by sound absorbing materials. So as you walk from the front of the vehicle toward the back, you'll see color-coded in here the things that are kind of gold shaded are sound absorption things. Things that are blue are sound absorbers, and things that are red are things that we did to reduce the sound level. And just as an example of reducing the noise level, if you look at the windshield wipers, you'll notice that they're of a structureless configuration. Basically, the arm attaches directly to the blade, there's not all that superstructure you typically see on blades. That keeps them out of the airstream, it keeps them low to the windshield, it also makes them extremely smooth and quiet in operation. So that's just one of the areas that we looked at to reduce the sound level. Also inside the car, we wanted to make sure when we did our HVAC systems that you had very, very good temperature control, and you need a fair amount of air movement to do that. Unfortunately, when you move a lot of air, it makes noise. So we spent a lot of time making sure that all the ducting was such that it really kept the air rush noise down to a minimum, even on a high blower setting. So it really did a superb job from that perspective to keep the noise out. We've got a laminated front of dash. If you look at a conventional front of dash material, it would be like this thing I've got in my hand. And it sounds kind of tinny. And what we've done is we've taken two sheets of steel and put some elastomeric material in between. And you can see that it really takes a lot of that noise out from the engine side, prevents it from getting into the passenger compartment. Other things we've done, if you look at the carpet is not just like the stuff you have in your house where there's a carpet and a separate mat that goes behind it. This is all kind of molded in one piece with the sound absorbing material molded right onto the carpet back, and can be tailored to be in the right places to do the best job overall on the interior. So as we walk through, you can see that we've also added various sound deadening patches throughout on the inside. Also in the rear on the wheel openings, we've added wheel house liners in order to keep the road noise out, and you will notice that this car does quite well on road noise reduction. Also in some of the channels and passageways that are inside the body, it can be a little bit like a bullhorn or a megaphone. You know, when you blow through a tube, it makes a lot of noise. You've got to seal off those passages. So wherever we have noise passages, we've also included some expandable foam, put it in the assembly process, it expands in the paint ovens and seals off those cavities to make it exceptionally quiet. And of course, also in the trunk, we've got a deck lid liner that also helps absorb that noise. So overall, it just makes an incredibly, incredibly quiet package. Again, you'll be able to experience that. We touch on the door over here, and then I'm gonna give you a little exercise on suspensions. But the thing I wanted to talk about here is you can also see we went into the door. We've actually added some acoustic absorbing pads that are part of the interior of the door that help absorb some of that road noise you get. And you notice this especially today if we're driving in traffic and trucks are going by. You'll notice it's a lot quieter than it might normally be. Of course, we've got from a structure standpoint the door beams for intrusion. And you can also see we've added sound deadening or absorbing material and then a kind of a sound blocker here with this. And we've also got laminated glass and all the moving side glass, so you've got two pieces of glass with a piece of plastic in between just like the windshield to again help keep out some of that high frequency noise. And then on the other side of this, I want to point out that we even went so far as on the mirrors. When we first started out, we were going to have a much more continuous surface on here, I guess is the best way to put it. When we put it in the wind tunnel, we found that we had a little bit more wind rush noise than we wanted. So these creases that you see here, which are not overly pronounced, but that made a huge difference on wind noise performance. So as the engineers went around their day-to-day jobs, they really spent a lot of time making sure that everything was really, really right, sweating all of the little details. So That was really the focus of what I wanted to point out. There's a lot of detail to this. There's a lot in your press kits that I won't be going through. But I encourage you to look through that because a lot of people spent a lot of time to make all this happen, to make sure it all played together. The last thing I want to show you here is a little bit of show and tell. We've got these things I want to get out to you. Don't start playing with them until you're instructed. And I want you to...
Okay.
All right, I'll give you this for the moment. Leave that there.
Okay.
You will notice that you have two syringes, and if you squeeze one, it'll push the opposite, you know, push on one and it'll move it to one side, just like a shock absorber works, basically. Shock absorber works by pushing fluid through a smaller orifice. And what magnetic ride control does is it changes the thickness of the fluid that's in here. This fluid is basically shock absorber fluid with metal particles suspended in it. On each of yours there should be a little magnet. And what I'd ask you to do is put that, move that magnet right to the center. Okay? And now try to push the plungers from one side to another. A little bit tougher, isn't it? And that's basically what magnetic ride control does, is by changing the magnetic field, you can go from very easy to push from one side to another to very difficult to push. And that provides you the right level of control. So when you're driving down the road in the CXS with magnetic ride control, normally the magnet is off and you'll be getting very fluid motion between both sides of the syringes, if you will. As you get into a handling situation where the vehicle wants more road control, the magnetic field picks up and all of a sudden it really ties the suspension down and makes it a lot firmer. But the advantage of that is you don't get the harshness when you're just cruising down the highway. So it's a tremendous improvement in overall ride character. So with that, I've said enough. I'm going to turn it over to Bill Peterson. Bill Peterson, as you said, is our vehicle performance manager, and he was one of the key guys responsible for making sure all these individual parts and pieces play well together.
Right. Okay. Thanks, Ed. Well, you've heard an awful lot about our quiet tuning process and all the components that we put into the Lucerne that will help it position it among the quiet leaders in its category. We obviously take noise control very seriously, and we pay attention to all the fine details that go into sound quality inside the Lucerne. One of the tools that we use in paying attention to those details is this guy here. Keep Mr. Rockin' Head. Okay. The typical acoustic memory of the human ear is only about 10 seconds long. So we use this digital recording tool to help us match very closely the way that we humans process sound. So with the Arianna head here, we are able to match the way that we digitally record with two microphones, one in each ear position, exactly the way the car sounds going down the road. So with Mr. Arianna head, we literally tune those Lucerne by ear. What it allowed us to do is to repeatedly test over and over again until we achieve the overall sound quality that we want to get inside the Lucerne. One thing that you'll see on the ride today is the overall lack of noise. Generally very low road noise. You'll notice that when you play with the HVAC system, there's generally a low amount of noise there. You can try even to sit in the back seat of the car, and you'll notice that you'll be able to hear the radio very clearly. You'll be able to hear the passengers in the front seat holding a conversation. All that helped us. We use the Arianna head to help quiet the overall noise level, so you're able to do those things. What we'd like to do for you is play a couple of recordings. We've brought recordings of the Buick Lucerne versus one of our key competitors here, and we've literally conducted hundreds of recordings over several months over different road conditions, wet and dry.
And they can test it, huh?
Yeah.
Who needs a pedal?
So what we've done is brought these recordings. What we're going to play for you here, and we typically do this in a quiet room at the open proving grounds. We've got three different noise recordings that we want you to hear. We want you to compare for yourself. You're going to play judge and jury and decide for yourself which one you think is the quietest. So I'm going to play these a couple of times. And the first recording we did. We did these at the proving grounds on our noise road course there. They're done back-to-back, same operating conditions. So we'll let you hear this first one here. This one was measured at 35 mile per hour on stud average concrete. That's a coarse concrete surface. So I'll play this one for you. I'll play it a couple times. Okay, so that's vehicle A versus vehicle B. I'll play it again. Surface that you heard first, we're at 60.6 dB. The average on the ES330 was 66 dB. You look at the 35 mile per hour smooth wet asphalt, again, that's sitting in the back seat. An awful lot of acoustic treatment in the car, those wheelhouse liners, that type of thing. Overall level, again, very noticeably different. That's almost a 6 dB difference, again, between the Lucerne and the ES330. That is extremely noticeable, as you can tell. And then finally, the 70 mile per hour cruising down the highway, Lucerne CX was at just about 53 dB, and the Lexus ES330 was 57. So, very noticeable differences. We think we're going to be able to make a claim that we are quietest in the entry market segment with our CX model, and at least as quiet with our up-level model, the CXS. So we're very excited about the noise performance. Any questions regarding any of the Ockenhead overview?